All right, so again, we're gonna work on moving around the pad. I can present the pad for strikes. I can swing and have him to Kevin cover. If I want to have him break ball, I'll say break ball as I swing. Break ball! Boom! But you go to break ball, he'll stand in base. And if I want him to sprawl, I level change and hit the ground. Boom! As if I'm moving for a takedown. Sit back up. Boom! Hold the pad out. So just 1 minute. Breathe. Again, if you have a partner, you're ready to go. Your partner's going to control the drill. But if not, follow along. Visualize. Do your best to get something out of it. Ready? And go! Play! Break ball! Single leg and transitioning to the ground, specifically to the mount, and again putting an emphasis on, look, if you have mats or a cushion at home, good technique and going through the motions and doing it like you would normally, but for the people working on a carpet or a hard floor, the real focus is, how do I do this safely? How do I transition from my feet to the ground without crashing? And then smoothly transition right now to the mount, just for control. So we were working from our rear strangle last class, and we will do that again. But for right now, we're actually gonna work from a grappling stance. Again, my guard stance, my hands are up higher, right? When I'm concerned about someone getting in my personal space in real life, they might try to punch me. Right now, if I'm working from our grappling stance, I don't have to worry about being punched. So my elbows are closer to my body, hands lower, feet are apart, a little wider, knees are bent. But again, eyes are forward, neck is strong, good position. Always moving again by opening my feet. I avoid crossing my feet unless I'm working some type of specific entry for something. But generally, feet are always moving open. And with my partner for now, we're going to work for just inside position, inside control, inside ties. With my palms tight, and then move forward, front foot, then back foot. My hands go inside Mr. Kevin's arms. And now he comes towards me a little bit. The goal being to open up my chest, getting my head as close as possible to his body. Again, if you don't have mats, I don't want you doing a penetration step, right? You can absolutely work just a snatch where I still keep weight on him, but I'll square my feet up, bending from my knees, and I'm sitting in a chair. Again, when I connect my hands, I don't grab the leg itself. I connect my hands, whether you go palm to palm or S-grip, it's your choice. Keeping my weight up. And again, I'm gonna step my foot back. Well, there's a dozen ways to finish this. We're just gonna pull his leg in, rotate. Mr. Kevin's gonna work on his sit. See, seated break fall coming down, and then I'm just gonna use control. I'm gonna push his knee in, transition right smooth to the ground, to the mount. One, two, make sure once I mount, get my feet hooked inside his knees and really work to either cross face and move my head and hand to the side, or if I'm gonna be centered, I'm not gonna be sitting here, make sure I don't let him control my arms. Right now, again, one more time, my feet. Just working for inside control. Squaring up as I come down. Focusing on really making sure that we're coming down with control, and then immediately pushing in on the knee, coming over, my feet hooking, and I'm mounting. So I want you to go through this transition. Whole drill will be 30 seconds. Super smooth, super relaxed. Again, if you have mats, you can go a little bit faster. But for right now, no submission. Just work on the transition and the control. 30 seconds. Ready? Up. Nice and slow, can't emphasize it enough. Safety, and working on building skill. Just one more, nice and controlled. Nice inside, head in. Again, my knee's not gonna touch. Up, step, turn. Really, he's doing the breakfall control, pushing in on his knees, coming down, getting my feet hooked underneath his legs. And time. So, let's work to review our strangle escape, and then work one more drill with that before we transition to a different technique. But for right now, Mr. Kevin comes up from behind, and he works on getting his arm around my neck. Again, you cannot overstate how important it is to have just general awareness, let alone situational awareness, to avoid letting things get put, you know, being put in the worst case scenario. If I really was not paying attention and I get caught by surprise, all the technique in the world is not going to help me if I don't have a mind that can endure suffering, right? Because the instant I can't breathe, everything hurts. The most natural instinct is almost to want to just, you know, go limp and hope it goes away. But we understand that to develop the mind that says, I'm going to fight that feeling. I'm going to feel that horrible feeling and not just, you know, wither. I'm going to turn it on. That can only be accomplished when you have a strong mind. And again, we develop, it's not something you develop overnight or in a week or in a month. It's something that you develop over years of hard training, safe, but hard training where you persevere, even though, you know, there's times, like I said, where you feel like you can't breathe, and it's not to be dramatic, but I wouldn't, you know, calling it suffering is not a, you know, too big of a term. So with that being said, in terms of what I can do, if I am in that position, hooking as close to his hand as possible can buy me, again, a moment. But it's really about me changing my angle, rotating, using my whole body, using my legs to rotate my shoulder into his sternum. So for this one, we're turning towards the hand, my chin to my shoulder to his chest, rotating, keeping my chest up. But once my shoulder's in his chest, right, he can't finish that strangle. I don't want to bend from my hips and get put in a side headlock. I want to keep my head up. I'm going to rotate, put my face into his body, and go to my body lock. But again, since we're not on mats, I don't want you to work your body lock. I think it's a very hard takedown, meaning in terms of the landing. So instead, or just to our single leg. So from the body lock, coming down, I'll lift. But again, we're using super control. As I take Mr. Kevin down, he break falls. He's careful not to smack his head, going super slow. I'm gonna do it one more time. One more time, you can watch again. You can have your partner do it with you if you want to really grab. For people who've done this a bunch, I do want you to work both sides, right? And especially people who are more experienced. I mean, this is a great thing because the technique's almost the same. I just have to know which way to rotate. All right, so I'm gonna give you 30 seconds just to practice. Eyes open, super relaxed. Mr. Kevin's gonna grab, I'll do it with you. Ready, 30 seconds. Take your partner grabs. Oh, boy. Now, if your partner doesn't feel comfortable with the falls yet, you can absolutely just stop at this point, realizing, you know, okay, from this point, I'm going to be ripping the person down to the ground. So you don't even have to have that fall if it's a problem. But if you can, this is a great opportunity to work on that breakfall. Keep going, keep going. We only have like 10 more seconds, 15 seconds. So he grabs. All right, so we're gonna work the eyes closed drill one more time. So I'll have Mr. Kevin stand, right? Eyes closed, physically relaxed, mentally thinking about something other than the fact that he's about to be grabbed. Because if we're going to try to simulate what it's like if we're caught off, I mean, we never want to be caught off guard, but if we are, our mind would be somewhere else. And so we want to simulate that by thinking about something else. Whenever I want, I grab. The moment I grab, he opens his eyes, does the move to escape. We're just going to have a very simple exercise. So every time he escapes, he drops, he does 5 push-ups. It's up to you. You do 5 or 10, all right? I don't want this to be a push-up drill, though, right? It's not how many push-ups can I do. It's just to add a little bit extra fatigue. So when you're up, eyes closed, breathing a little bit harder, and it slows your reactions a little bit. So again, we'll go eyes closed, just 1 minute. Grab. Again, people with more experience work both sides. Obviously, everything we're doing should be tailored to your level of safety. And if you don't have a partner, then you should close your eyes. And when you hear me grab Mr. Kevin, you open your eyes, do the escape, go through the motions. Everyone has a partner you're gonna grab, keep it safe. But when you grab, remember, it should be startling because the idea here is that this person was not paying attention. 1 minute, all right, Mr. Kevin. So again, I'll grab, opens his eyes, escapes, takes me down with control, does create space, 5 push-ups. Again, if you want to do 10, it's up to you, but 5 or 10, back eyes closed. Ready? 1 minute. Echo! Play! Echo! Play! Until you create space. Eyes closed. Ah! Good push-ups, breathing out on the way up. Eyes are closed, less than 30 seconds. Great work, everyone. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be back with the next part, doing our groundwork. Awesome job.